हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू टेक ग्रंथ। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर बिग डेटा जर्नी विद दिस लेक्चर और सेशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर फर्स्ट सेशन ऑन द बिग डेटा प्लेटफॉर्म। राइट, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज डेटा और व्हाट इज बिग डेटा। राइट, सो लेट्स सी फर्स्ट व्हाट इज डेटा। सो यू कैन सी माई स्क्रीन राइट here on the left hand side you can see just a single page of any book you can consider, right? That is having written something which is we can consider as a information, right? Then those are the pages like about 1000 pages you can, if you collect within a book, that book will have some more information as compared to that single page, right? And if you will have multiple books together, then it will incorporate more information and more data, right? And then if we will have thousands or more than thousands of books together, we will have this kind of situation, right? We have to organize the data. We have to store that somewhere, right? And we can store that in different ways, right? If I'll say this in the below picture, you can say it unstructured, right? So this is not managed or put together properly, right? Then on the second picture, you can see some of the books are organized properly, but some of them still lying around. So that we can see, we can say semi-structured, right? Half is structured and half is not, right? And on the above one, you can see all the books are organized in a library on the racks, right? And that is properly structured, right? So as I mentioned that we start from a single one page and we have just a small information and it grows day by day. And you can see now we have library and that can have huge amount of information, right? So let me just put a size it to this, right? Then we will see. Yeah, right now you can see that if you consider this page information as of size megabyte, just MB, right? And then we have about 1000 MBs can be together a 1 GB gigabyte. Then multiple gigabyte or multiple books can have information about the size of 1 TB. And then together, if we took it to the library, those books together or that size together will become multiple terabytes, and then it can be petabytes. Or you can see in the left hand side below corner that there are various units to measure the data, right? Byte, kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, and those can go up to zettabyte, yottabyte, and zettabyte. So from this slide, we can get two things at least, right? That volume of this information is growing, right? From megabyte to petabyte and zettabyte, right? Exabyte, okay. Second thing, we can have a different organization way, right? How we organize these structured, semi-structured, and unstructured. So this info, if we call this information as a data, then we have a data volume, right? And data variety. How three types of data we are having: structured, semi-structured, and unstructured, right? But as this was an example of books, so on the information written on books was not earlier considered as data, right? Because data can be considered as characters or symbols on which any computer can perform some operation like storage or processing and transfer those that information through the electrical signals, so right? So the main thing is that we can consider data which can be used by computer, right? And this was not the earlier that data. So let's see then what, from where that data comes which can be consumed or stored or processed by computer, right? So we have different sources for that on the basis of that example I showed in last slide. We have different type of sources, right? Social data, which we are using daily, day by day on our social website like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and these days TikTok is popular, right? So, and WhatsApp and other Telegram. There are many applications which you might be using in your social connectivity. And apart from that, we have mobiles data. As you have known, that about every person in the world is using a mobile on an average, if we calculate. So they are using a mobile for GPS connectivity and to get the location of somewhere, right? And when they are making calls, then they are generating data as a call data records, which is known as CDR, right? So those are also generating data. Then we have shoppings, either it is online or offline. We are going to shopping malls and buy something. Then we are having their transactions and many things. So they are also generating data. If we are shopping on online, then we are searching for the products and taking it to the cart, making payments, doing transactions, and then our product got shipped and delivered to us. Then, so all those things are at the back end is also getting generated data, because everything you can see that everything is going through internet and made through the computers or laptops, right? Then we have activity generated data, which you usually we search on internet, or we perform browse any websites or anything we do on internet or computers or anywhere, right? So that also generating data. And then we have satellite imagery. We don't know about those, but still we have many satellites in the universe which are working 24 by 7, and they are also generating huge amount of data on the daily basis. Then we have airlines, automobiles, and healthcare industries, where everyone is contributing a huge amount of data to the to this big data. Then for our support and our queries to resolve our issues, we have we usually talk to call centers for most of the products, and they also having our call records as data, right? And our feedbacks and reviews. So those are also the info data generated in huge amount. Then we have financial data, like in banks, when we have transaction or ATM transaction, or how whichever type of transactions we are doing for our banking purpose, and in insurance as well, when we are raising claims and getting our claim. So on the back end, they are also generating a large amount of data, which is considered as a big data. Then we have educational, right? Earlier we were about we used to read books, right? Now all the books and all the topic lessons, everything we can study on the internet, on our mobile phones, right? Then we have entertainment industries, like we have seen these days everything on internet or using the internet, like Netflix, YouTube, and Amazon Prime, and other video series we used to have on internet, right, on our mobiles. So that is also contributing a large amount of data. Then we have smart, these days you must have listened, smart devices, right? We have smart watch, smart phones, smart homes, smart cities as well. So on those smart things, we are using lot of sensors, right? Different kind of sensor, thermostats, and all those kind of sensors in our autonomous vehicles as well, which are also smart. So those are every second they might be generating huge data. So those were analyzed by the systems. Then we have databases, where we are having custom relationship management data and their workflow data. And also ERP, enterprise resource planning data, those are stored in databases. Those database terminologies or technology, but they are also contributing to the big data. Then we have networking and monitoring. All as you can see, everything is connecting to internet now, and they must have connected to each other with networks, and we have to monitor those network to get the availability of those resources or devices or products. So those are also generating data. Then we also have cloud computing these days, that everything we can, every system, either servers or other technologies, we can build on top of clouds, right? And they are also, because they are using data centers and machines and other things as well, networking devices, so they also connecting to each other, so those are also generating data. So ultimately, all together with these data sources, we are generating a tremendous and huge amount of data, right? So if we will go with the some facts, let me show you some details that how much data we are generating. So in this year 2020, we have about 4 billion connected peoples, which are connected to each other through the internet or different devices or by social connectivity and all those things, right? We are using 25 plus million applications, okay? Because to these days, we are getting everything on applications. We calls them as apps, right? Mobile apps or TV apps or those things. You can see that there are 20 billion IoT devices which are generating data. There are 20 to 50 petabytes of data generated by smart cities per day, and on an average, a person on this earth is generating 1.5 GB data per day. And if you consider smart homes, not in India right now, but yes, in future it will be, and they are generating 50 GB data per day. And we also using different appliances in our home or in offices, right? Smart Wi-Fi, smart TV, smart mobile, smart watch, smart bulbs, smart refrigerator, and all those things. So they are also generating about 150 GB data per day. And if we consider autonomous vehicle, which is you must have heard about driverless cars or driverless metros, right? So those are also generating about 5 TB data per day. And then you can see whenever there is any program or any match in stadium, those are generating 200 TB data per game and in those stadiums. And we have connected factories, right, to automate the things and automate the product manufacturing, and different kind of automations are having, those are also generating about 1 petabyte data per day. So on below, you can see that I have put here that in 2005 we were just having 0.1 zettabyte data, right? In 2010, it just increased to 1.2 zettabyte. In 2012, it increased to 2.8 zettabyte, and in 2015, it was about 8.5 zettabyte. So from 2015 to 2020, current year, we have increased by 5 to 6 times. So we have just generated about 40 plus zettabyte data since 2015 to 2020, and now in 2020 we are having about 50 zettabyte of data, and about 40% of data are generated by machines, sensors, and all those devices and tools. So this was the volume part of data generated by us, right, on a daily basis or up to now, how much data we have generated. So let's see other terminology, that how we organized or categorized these data, right? As I saw in that book example, we have unstructured, semi-structured, and unstructured, right? So let me now we will discuss how we organize that big data, right? So first of all, you can see structured data, right? Structured data is which is having definite schema or structure, or that can be stored in table. For an example, you have seen Microsoft Excel, right? There we have rows and columns, and we can store information there. So just like that, we have databases, okay, where we can store information or data in rows and table formats. So in the earlier 1970s, those type of data were processed easily at that time, and that was about e-commerce data, shopping cart data, product and sales data, and those kind of data. And there were some tools and systems like Oracle and Sun systems which were having the capacity of processing and storing that data, and but they were quite expensive, and they were there were some limitations to expand the configuration of those systems. Like we could just expand their RAM, cores, or storage just up to an limit, and that was the limitation of those systems. So at that time, we just able to process only that 10 to 15% of data, and as I said, that was CRM, ERP, payments, transaction, Excel, online forms data, right? Then we have semi-structured data, right, and which is about 10% only. That is that metadata provides a structure there, and that cannot be stored in tables like the structured data. So this type of data can be XML, social media data, email, server logs, text messages, and blogs, reviews, and customer feedbacks. So those kind of data can be considered as semi-structured data. But that is not that much easy to process or store as compared to structured data. Then we have third one, unstructured data, that is about 70% of total data, and it do not have any definite schema or structure, and those were just like I have shown in that book video that all the books lying around scattered and not organized. So this unstructured data examples can be photos, videos, and audios, and documents which we shared on social media, right? And then we have machine generated data, that like these days you must have seen RFID, radio frequency identification, and tags which used and toll tags are in our vehicles, right? Then we have sensors, GPS data, and smart meters, or CCTV, weather, voicemail, and recording data. Those can be considered as unstructured data. So as I told that we were able to only process the structured data, then how let me just brief how we process that, or how we stored the data, right? So at that time we were just using RDBMS systems, which was a relational database management system. So those were managing relational databases, like right? So we were having a different kind of databases where we can store the data and use SQL queries on them to process that data. SQL queries, structured query language, that was specifically used to query the data from those databases. So we have we were having Oracle, MySQL, Postgres SQL, Microsoft SQL Server, Teradata, and those kind of systems, and which can handle these kind of databases. But now these days we are having NoSQL databases as well. I'll show you detail of these databases in our future videos, but just to brief, we are having different kind of NoSQL databases like key value store database, document store, right, where we then we have column oriented, then graph, database, search engine, and time series database. And some of new RDBMS databases evolved during the time, which is right now BigQuery, that used by Google right now and earlier as well. Then we have Hive, Impala, Spark SQL, NetAgent, and Snowflake. So these kind of databases which are used these days with all these RDBMS databases. So from these databases, earlier we just used to run queries and get the result out of it as that reports or just like yeah reports right for analytics and all those purpose. So right now we have seen two types of okay, just let's move. Yeah, till now we just see two type of characteristics of big data, right? That first is volume, that we were having a huge amount of data coming from different data sources. Then we have variety, that we they're like unstructured, semi-structured, and structured. Third is velocity, that how the data is coming. That I have showed you that since 2015 to 2020 we have increased 40 zettabyte of data. That data is coming so fast that the third characteristics we can consider as velocity, that we are getting data in streaming mode as well. And that streaming data is capable to enable decisions with a fraction of seconds. So we can make decisions in real time because of that streaming data, right? We will see that them in later in future videos. Then these were the these were called the three V's earlier for big data characteristics. But right now these V's are also evolving. So right now we can see veracity and value also. Veracity, where we have the data uncertainty, that is the data is quite useful, that if it is having null value or that managing that reliability and predictability of inherently imprecise data types, that if this is having a null value or correct value or those kind of uncertainty about that data. Then we have value, right? The fifth V, and that is data usability, that if we can get that output or if that data is useful for us, right, which can be considered for decision making, where the count or number does not matter, but the insight does, where we can get visualization out of that data, and we can make some important decisions on the basis of those insights. So right now you maybe may see that these five V's of big data, those are called. And apart from these, we have some other that you may see in future as well, right? On the left hand side you can see that which we discussed just now, five V's, right? Volume, velocity, variety, veracity, and value. Then on the right hand side you can see another five V's which you might have seen in future. So first of these is validity, that up to which extent or which up to what time we can have the data in our system storage, right? And about that data quality and governance and most data management on massive scale. So it decide that we have to get have that data on our storage till 3 years at least, or maybe 1 year or 1 month at maybe. And after that duration, we can move that data to some archival storage, which can be used as historical data, right? And that will not be used daily or frequently. So that can be taken as validity, which type of data we'll be using on a daily basis or quarterly or as soon as possible, right? And which data can be taken into archival. Then we have variability. Variability is about the data types or data source types that on the as the technology is getting evolved and products are getting upgraded, and so the very data sources can be dynamic, or their behavior can be changed for the data sources, right? Then we have a venue where we will consider distributed heterogeneous data from multiple platforms like cloud or data center, on-prem data center, or healthcare, or multiple data platforms, right? Then we have vocabulary, which use data models or semantics that will describe the data structure in future, right? And then we have vagueness, where it will show the con that we have confusion over meaning of big data and the tools used for that big data to process or store that big data, as there are many industries or organization are still confused that we whichever big whichever data we should consider as big data and which tools we should use to process that big data. So these are the V's. Right, you can see in future as well, or you might have seen in the past in another blogs or videos or some anywhere. Right now, you have seen that we got the data, right? We organize the data in different varieties, or we have seen big data characteristics, the right that what can be big data. Now we will see why big data is important, right? We have talked so much about that big data, but we are not came to the point that how we will use that data, what are the benefits of this big data. So let's see why big data is important to us. So with the combination of that structure, unstructured and semi-structured data, that big data has become a broad term for data sets or complex that they are difficult to process using traditional data processing applications or systems, because there are many challenges, which includes analysis of that unstructured or semi-structured data, how to capture or get the data from the data sources, right? The curation of the data, searching out something, some important or useful information from that data, then sharing the data, then store, transfer, visualize the data and information privacy, also the security of the data, because it is having every large information, so there should be some more security for that. So to overcome these challenges, the next term which you might have heard, that Hadoop ecosystem or Hadoop technology came into the picture to overcome these challenges. That Hadoop technology can be used to analysis, to capture, to search, sharing, storage, transfer, to visualize, and that big data, and obviously with the security as well. But what we get that after using that Hadoop technology as well. So with that technology, we have big data analytics tools and machine learning and different technologies in that Hadoop ecosystem, which saves our cost, right, to get the products easy or faster to the market, right, and to make correct decisions, right, on the basis of that big data. And there are many things which saves our cost, right? Then we have time reduction, that if you have seen that whenever a mobile launch, right, or you use that mobile and you give the feedback on their websites and all those things, they ask us to give feedback about how this new mobile is, or how what are the features it is lacking of. So in the next product, they will incorporate those features and those issues they have resolved, and then bring the new product. And within a small fraction of time, Like you must have seen that on Flipkart we usually get sales every month, right? So how they change their product within that small amount of time. So that time is reduction because of those feedbacks, and they just stop their manufacturing of old products and start the new one with the new features. So those kind of decisions are easier to make with big data information only. Then we next is understand the market condition. So on our behavior, on our feedback or reviews, manufacturing companies or any organization can take decisions, right? And they can understand the market condition, what is happening, where they can provide their product, and where they can supply more or less, or which product will work in which market, right? Those kind of decisions can be taken. Then we have control of online reputation, that we have put our thoughts, our views or our likes, dislikes, comments on social networking sites, right? On the basis of those, we are generating data or information about ourselves, that what we like or dislike, right? So to analyze those information, we have a technology called sentiment analysis. On that, with that technology, with sentimental analysis, they can get the information about our behavior, and they can change their strategies, or they can understand about the behavior, right? Then we have customer acquisition and retentions. Like you must have seen on about internet or mobile plan network provider, right? Airtel or Jio, or so they have MNP functionality, multi network portability, right? So with that, they just have the customer care information, that we told them this network is not coming, or I am not getting it useful for me, and I want to switch to some other network provider. So to retain those customers, they just got that information and provide them some other benefits, right? The offers or some benefits which able to retain those customers back. So those are also important, and on the basis of big data information, that can be used to retain those customer retention, right? New products and services offer marketing insights, right? We have, as we discussed, the companies can analyze and check which product is selling faster or selling more in which area, or which they can get those insights from that information. Then we have innovation and product development. Then on the basis of those feedbacks or old historical data or many other information, we can innovate the new things and new products, and even faster and more reliable. Then we have faster and better decision making. We analyzing those information, we can take quick and faster decisions. On the like I told about the streaming application or streaming data, right? On the basis of that streaming data, we can provide which videos or which products you should buy. And those were the main benefits of that big data, or all those information which we are getting generated day by day in the huge amount. In the education industry, we can customize or make dynamic learning programs, reframing our course materials, and then we can create grading systems, and also we can use that information about the career prediction, right? We can predict what will be the job opportunities in future, right? Those are also important in educational industry. Then we can see in insurance sector, we collect all the information about the customers, and All the those details are beneficial to gain the customer insights and fraud detection and threat mapping also. And not only in the private sectors, the big data is also getting used in government industries as well for creating welfare schemes, right? And to you control on cyber security and all those things they are using in government sector as well. Then we can also see in banking sector the misuse of credit cards or debit cards that can be controlled using those information, and we can have business clarity and customer statistics alteration, money laundering and risk mitigations, all those features we can get out of this big data. So that's all for the big data. We have already discussed what is big data, what are the characteristics of big data, what are the benefits of big data, how we can recognize the big data, how we can use big data, right? So where we can use big data. So now the problem is how we will manage, and we will manage like how we'll store the data, this big data, how we'll process this big data, or how we'll analyze this data, right? So that part is will be taken care by Hadoop ecosystem tools, and those I will show you in our next videos. So that's all for this session. Thank you so much for watching, and keep sharing and keep learning. Thank you.